Hello and welcome to K-Stop, Fuse's Case Pop Podcast. Thanks as always for tuning in. This is Jeff, and if I'm the Sunny, she's the Yuna. It's Tina Zoo.
Hello.
What's up, Tina? Good
Not
to see
much.
You.
Not much. Yeah. Glad to be back on K-Stop with another episode.
Another episode. I'm a little under the weather, so if you hear me sniffling a little bit, granted, the sight of Tina full-fledged in front of me is helping things, but...
Jeff actually doesn't sound congested at all, which is crazy because he's been, like, sniffling and blowing his nose. So this is very, like... That's crazy. I feel like most people, they sound like a different person.
I'm faking it really well. But hello, everybody. Thank you so much for tuning in. Yeah, it's been a great week, or maybe a quieter week, but I feel like things are just about to ramp up. It's almost summer. K-pop summers are always really exciting, so I'm very excited to see what we get into and what the month of June holds and all that fun stuff.
Yeah.
So we got to give a quick shout-out, as we always do, because we say you guys are as much of the show as we are, which is why there are so many different ways for you to interact with K-Stop. You can... listen to us on Fuse.tv, where we stream every episode. You can go to iTunes, where you, of course, get, you know, automatic updates on your phone when you subscribe. Slacker, these are on YouTube. So many different things that you guys can listen to us on and leave comments on, because we love the comments.
No excuse not to tune in.
Yeah, seriously. But, yeah, and we always see your comments if you use the K-Stop hashtag. And in particular, got to give a shout-out to John Kiddo, who is at JohnKiddo167 on Twitter, who wrote, "I am so excited for this week's K-Stop podcast. Can't wait," because I guess I can give a little spoiler of some people we're talking to this week. He was really excited about UKISS and EXID's comeback.
Yes,
so,
two big comebacks.
Yeah, so we're excited too, and we're excited that you're excited. So thank you so much, as always. And now, you know, another big part of how we include you guys on the podcast is we give you a poll of the music releases that we list every week, and we ask you guys to vote all week and decide who was the top release of the week. And right now, as we film this episode, voting is officially closed to see who was the favorite K-pop release of last week. And if you remember, we talked about Icons, WID, Luna's Free Somebody, and Zia's Rock the World. Those were the singles of release last week. Who do you think won?
I am going to guess Luna.
Because that SMFX love.
Yeah, I feel like there's a lot of support for her. And also, it's just a really, really solid release.
Yeah, we loved that one in particular. But I got to say, Tina, she got in second place this
really?
Year.
Really? Was it Icon?
It was Icon.
Okay.
75% of the Fuse.tv votes went to WYD, which... yeah, we love that track anyway. But yeah. And then Luna came.
I think YG fans go super hard too.
They go hard. And I think Icon is a very excited fan base. I think they were really happy that they were back.
For sure.
Yeah.
I'm totally good with that too. So.
Totally cool. And then Luna was in second place with 23% of the votes. And then Zia, what the heck, with 2%. But, you know, still respectable, going against some big competition. So
yeah, I feel like Junsu is like. He's, I don't know how to explain it. Like, he's always going to have a lot of fans. But I guess, you know, as you get older, it's hard to really, you know, go up against those really trendy, you know, newish people. But, he has a very different sound, too. So might not resonate with everyone.
Exactly. And, you know, he can still sell out tours, still sell out shows, you know. I'm sure he's doing it just fine. And don't forget, I'm looking at the tallies right now, and these are people, you know, everyone got like a respectable amount of votes this year. Mm-hmm. They're going against people who are getting thousands and thousands of votes. So, you know what? Shout out to Junsu.
Yes.
Still respectable. So thank you guys. Thanks everyone who voted, who tuned in, who wanted to have their voice heard. So yes, before we continue on, just a quick couple housekeeping notes. If you're digging K-Stop, please leave us a comment wherever. You can use the Twitter hashtag K-Stop. We see them all. You can at us on Twitter. Feel free to hit me up. My Twitter name, I should say, is at Jeff_Benjamin.
And I am at Hey_Tina with 3 A's.
Yeah.
Please tweet us.
Please do. We love it. And also be sure to give a rating on iTunes. We love that. It helps us. It helps everyone, keeps us happy, et cetera. So please do. But, you know, let's get right into some music because that's what we're really here for. Tina, who do you want to kick us off with?
Well, everyone's so excited about EXID. So let's kick it off with EXID.
Trendy girl group.
Yeah.
As everyone knows, here's the thing. Okay, so I got to give quick backstory on EXID because I always really loved this group. They were so like quirky and like different with their early releases. They but got like no attention, you know?
It's very surprising. Sorry to cut you off, but no, I was just going to say I'm very surprised because I've always appreciated their releases.
Yeah.
And, you know, L.I.E is, you know, so badass and she sounds so distinct and she's worked with, you know, Hyuna and like, you know, other artists. And I just felt like usually when you have that standout, really kind of like aggressive member, that the group will kind of like
follow,
also rise with that member.
Right.
But I don't know, like I feel like they definitely, like you said, are a little bit underrated or like overshadowed.
It took some time, you know.
Yeah.
And then like, you know, they had this kind of crazy story at the end of 2014 where this viral fan recorded camera, fan cam as you call them, like of one of the members, Hani. Like it was just this, you know, they're very, you know, sexy dancing or whatever. And, you know, it just took off. And I was just reading the other day that it hit this like fan recorded video, not high quality at all, just like focused on her, just watching her, you know. K-pop fans know this is called fan cams, but hit it 20 million views, which is like,
that's insane.
Crazy, you know. And like just that, you know, it's just some guy who recorded it. So, and that really shot them to this sort of other realm of popularity. And they're really up there
it
now.
It always helps when you go viral.
It always helps when you go viral, right? So, and then that song ended up going like number one, this like old song, you know. So, and they've kind of been following up, in my opinion, with very consistent releases, and that includes this latest L.I.E. or Lie, as some might call it.
Yes.
And are you a fan of it?
I'm gonna be honest, I think it's I like maybe 30% of it.
Okay.
And that's like the non-pop 30%, because they basically took two completely different songs, sections of each, and just like threw it together.
Yeah.
It's very, very sudden and jarring how they went from the kind of generic pop sound, which I don't care for. That whole first like
the
section, I don't care for. And then it suddenly went into this like really dope beat, and obviously like L.I.E, like, you know, went in on her verse, and I really like that. And I don't know, it's just kind of strange. I don't think that kind of very schizophrenic kind of sound worked this time around versus like something, I guess this isn't like the same thing, but the closest I can think of is 4 Minutes.
I was gonna bring that one up.
Yeah,
because you like that one.
I love that one, but that one was different because it's still kind of like eased into it a little bit.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Section to section. It wasn't, it still felt like the same song.
Yeah.
Whereas this one is just, I don't know what was happening.
I see what you're saying.
Because
4 Minute did kind of build into, it got like, it was slow and then it got more intense and more intense.
I could see like the overall, like the concept working for 4 Minute. Whereas this one, honestly, like, it just gives me completely different vibes, the two sections. Like, I feel like they had no tie-in. I don't know if you agree, but that's just, I felt like it was just really annoying.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, that's the thing is that, well, one, just I feel like in pop music in general, I feel like we're seeing a lot more, and this is totally Diplo and Skrillex and Jack Yu's fault, if you want to call it that.
They just
love that, like, complete, like, beat drop and, like, song flipped on its head sort of thing, because these songs, it reminds me of two separate pop songs. The first part, the breezy pop part that you were talking about, it reminds me of Miley Cyrus's We Can't Stop. That,
oh my God. That's probably why I don't like it.
I always sing them over each other.
It actually sounds very similar to that.
Yeah. You can totally go, red bodice, red bodice, everywhere. You know, you can. It totally works, believe me. And then the beat drop part or whatever, it reminds me of Bitch on Madonna, the Madonna song, which is Diplo produced. And because like that is very similar to that. And I almost wonder, like, because this actually isn't the first time EXID kind of took like not that those are the hugest songs, but in their last release, the Hot Pink song, if you remember that one from last year, it had that
the gas station one. Yes. I think they were at a gas station.
The gas station one, as Tina puts it. No, it had the Take Me to the Mardi Gras song. And that's a song that Missy Elliott made really famous on the Work It beat. Mm-hmm. The like jangly sort of beat, you know. Yeah. It's like Yep. So they get a lot of influences, I see, from, or at least I feel like, from like other pop songs, which is kind of interesting.
I appreciate how it is very unconventional.
It's quirky.
Yeah.
You know, I agree. Maybe it's, I think I like Hot Pink more. I think I like Up and Down more. I think I really love this song called Every Night that they released way before they were popular. That was one of like my favorite songs of that year. I think it was 2013. I don't know. I'm very curious to see how it does. You know, it's a fun song overall. I think I really like the choruses in particular when you have Solji and Hyerin like kind of like belting it out, and you know, I like that part. I think there's good vocals. Mm-hmm. You know, I really like Ellie's part. That part is like when she went into Nicki Minaj mode.
Right. She looked so different in this video. I think the hairstyling really threw me off.
A lot of people are commenting on the style.
It almost didn't really look like her. It was a little strange.
I didn't see that. I thought she looked looks like awesome in my opinion.
I don't know. I didn't think she looked bad. I think just the hair was very, because usually it's like slick and like long and sleek and
This is more glamour.
This one was more, she like dyed it lighter, I think, and it was almost like frizzier and tied back.
Okay.
So
turn on a little more volume.
It was a look that I didn't really expect, but nice. The video I thought was really cool. I thought it was a cool concept, like the hotel concept. Like you said, it was very quirky. I think all their videos really stand out.
And, you know, they're kind of, I don't know if you saw this, but there was like a little bit of controversy, shock, that that there was like some sexual imagery in it.
Yeah, there was like, they were seasoning meat.
Yeah.
With like the salt or the pepper, the shaker.
Yeah.
And it looked a little bit suggestive. Yeah. I'm not going to lie. And
But I was kind of like, oh, come on.
It wasn't like that bad,
but I was kind of like, all right. Yeah. I mean, like clearly, you know, it's not.
It wasn't like super explicit and that it was just like thrown in your face or anything. Yeah. But, you know, here and there is a little bit.
I think that's
kept you on your toes.
Exactly. That's how I mostly felt about it. I was like, okay. Yeah. You know, they kind of blew up because of the more, you know, sexual, you know, if you will, sort of looks and whatnot. Yeah. It's like, why not throw it in there? Right. You know, like it wasn't, like you said, it was kind of, it did sort of keep you on your toes.
Right. And it was like, there were just like kind of moments.
Yeah.
Yeah. It
wasn't like
explicit.
The video.
I mean, I don't know. There were a couple moments where I forget the member's name, but the redhead, excuse me.
Oh, Solji?
Yeah. She was like kind of in suggestive poses on the floor and stuff like that. And I was like, I don't know if that's like kind of just, I don't know. I wouldn't call that sexy, but it was just, it was suggestive.
Yeah.
I don't know. I feel like in general, the people weren't like mad about it. They're like, oh, that's like kind of risque.
Right. Which is kind of, I just always think it's funny when these things become like trending topics.
Right.
You know?
Just because it's not something you see too often in K-pop videos with, you know, with females, you know, they try to keep it more proper than anything, you know?
And I'm like, go, you know, and I'm kind of curious, you know, just overall, like looking ahead, because I feel like the sexy trend has sort of died down a tiny bit in K-pop. Mm-hmm. You know, there was hardcore for a while, and now it's kind of like died down, in my opinion. I think we're seeing more of the innocent stuff, you know, dreamy mm-hmm. stuff making more or being much more prevalent, mm-hmm. I should say. But I'm kind of curious how they do, and you know, if Girls' Day will do something similar when mm-hmm. Girls' Day comes back.
Yeah.
So, because I feel like they're kind of holding the torch of like, or like, you know, if Sistar does something like that.
Right.
So, I don't know. I'm kind of curious to see what this summer holds
yeah.
in terms of sexiness. But, yeah, let us know what, you know, of course, this is the lead single from their first full-length debut album. I personally got to admit, I have to finish the album. But, yeah, I'm very proud of them. I'm excited that they're still doing it, still going hard, and go EXID. So if they're your number one pick of the week, definitely vote in our poll or let us know what you guys think of sexy people in general. You can also let us know about that, because I'm always down to talk about some sexy people. And
speaking of sexy people.
Yeah, where's that leading us to, Tina?
I think we should talk about Heize and Dean.
Ooh, very sexy.
I think they're both
people.
Very sexy.
All right.
Yeah, I thought the video was really sexy.
I agree.
For their song Shut Up and Groove.
Yes, a collaboration between Heize.
Yeah, and this is the third time that we've talked about Dean. We just love him so much.
We do. He was just in New York this weekend.
He was, yeah.
We were
unable to meet.
We were at different commitments, yeah. You know. But I heard
Jeff was being rained on.
I was
at Gov Ball.
Don't even talk to me about it. No, just kidding. It was a fun time. If you guys don't know, Governor's Ball is a big New York City festival. It rained a lot, and I loathe the rain, so I was miserable in the rain while I was being showered on. But you know, it was a fun time. But Dean was in town, yeah, and I don't know if you heard about this, but they changed the venue last minute because
Cabana?
Yeah, well.
Yeah, that was a legendary nightclub, as they call it. Hot mess. Anyway.
Wow. I didn't know this history.
I mean, any midtown club?
Yeah.
No, thank you.
Oh.
Yeah.
Do not take note, people. Never take Tina to a midtown club, okay? I've just learned my lesson. She prefers a nice, quiet bar, wine bar. It doesn't even have to be quiet, right? You like a good bar.
It's more ideally quiet, but ideally not like smack in the middle of like Times Square-ish area.
Yeah, which is what that means. But anyway, we're getting sidetracked here because Dean had to relocate into, you know, he went a little more downtown. But I was hearing about it from a friend of mine, actually. Shout out to my friend Ellie Hu, who was at the show. And she was telling me about this. And yeah, they switched it last minute because I guess there was some type of sound issues or he wasn't hearing himself well, which is interesting because I'm like, okay, at least he cares about that, you know.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like a lot of K-pop concerts are honestly plagued by really bad sound issues.
Yeah.
So good for him, I guess, for noticing. But yeah, they changed it. I've heard mixed reviews about how it was all handled and whatnot. And, you know, it was a shorter concert from what I understand. But yeah, good for Dean. First New York show. So, you know, of course, nothing is ever easy. So.
Right. Well, that's K-pop. Like that's awesome that they like at least got it handled.
Yeah. No, exactly.
Yeah.
But great. But yeah. You know, sorry, getting us back to the actual show.
Yeah.
Heize and Dean, Shut Up and Groove. I am so digging this track. In particular because I always knew Heize is kind of like, you know, she blew up on Unpretty Rap Star, the female rap competition show, which is really, really popular in Korea. And then Dean brought his sort of, you know, grooving, you know, low vibey sound.
Yeah,
and she, I feel like, took a page from him and really, you know, made this really nice meeting of their two styles.
Yeah. It sounded like dreamy, trancey, but still kind of like upbeat lounge club vibe.
Right.
And
I was so into
she
it.
Pronounces her name Heize, right?
It's like Hazy, maybe?
Because I know it's definitely either Heize or I think she's I think she like changed the pronunciation of Heize. Her name is taken from Angel Haze's last name because she really likes Angel Haze. And I think she tweaked the phonetic pronunciation of that and then changed the spelling because apparently I think that's a German word to like heat something up.
Oh.
And that's why she liked, and obviously she likes that definition and,
I
you know,
love
and
that.
She brings a lot of fire and edge to her, you know, the way she delivers her verses. I just forget, like, I can't remember if I've seen the Korean phonetic translation, if it's Heize or if she kept it Haze. But it, I feel like it makes sense if it's German, it should be Heize.
Yeah.
Because that vowel sound is German.
Yeah. I did a quick Google, try to do a little research, and I feel like it's Heize.
Heize, right?
Yeah, please don't hate us if we pronounce it wrong.
I think it is Heize. yeah.
But cool backstory. I didn't know that.
Yeah, I thought that was really cool, like that, you know, she took someone very relevant in, I guess, our rap industry,
yeah.
And then she kind of, but it wasn't just like, oh, I'm taking her last name, because that wouldn't really like make her point of being different and
right.
You know,
yeah,
being edgy. So I really like how she kind of tweaked it and made it unique.
Love it.
And
she was kind of like a breakout artist on, like, you know,
yeah,
the show and everything, and you know, so it's really cool to see that she's kind of keep being supported, doing mm-hmm. cool collaborations and whatnot. And
yeah,
I love this, you know, and I thought, you know, even though she's known as a rapper, she's kind of giving, like, she gave vocals, like, on this track, like, you know, kind of, like,
right,
met with Dean in that world that he
right.
lives in particular. So I thought that was so cool. And, you know,
right.
she has a really sweet.
I think they did mesh their sounds very well.
Yeah.
I appreciated how the video was kind of trippy.
Mm, yeah.
It kind of, it gave me like very kind of like old school vibes. And,
yeah.
But like they also kept it very simple, kind of like speeding through the city.
Yeah.
But obviously like they weren't like actually like going through the city the whole time. And
right.
They were just like kind of like vibing in their car.
Yeah.
Yeah, and like I just thought the production of it was really cool.
I loved all the cuts to like the instruments and like the beats, you know,
yeah,
and like the like clicking the beats, you know, and whatnot. So yeah, and I thought they were both styled really well. They both look really
mm-hmm.
good. Like all around I am feeling
this. She kind of looks a little bit like a taller like Taeyong from Girls' Generation.
Oh.
Maybe it's the hair. I don't know.
It might have been.
A little bit. Her eyes aren't as big.
It's interesting that you brought up an SM artist because I thought the video kind of reminded me of, do you remember Red Velvet's Automatic video? And it might just
mm-hmm.
be the car scene because like they have this sort of like trippy car scene
yeah.
where they're like also going and there's all these colors and whatnot.
Yeah.
And
it felt kind of like dreamlike.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it kind of wore. And I think their sounds, yeah, totally. Or the video nicely coincided with the sound that they were
right.
creating in the song.
But what I thought was interesting was that it didn't match the lyrics.
Ooh.
I mean, the lyrics, like, obviously the chorus was, like, shut up and groove. And, like, you would assume that it's, like a happier song. Like, oh, just dance. But, like, she's saying just shut up and dance because I don't want to think about how messed up my love life is. The verses are, like, oh, yeah, I don't relate to these lyrics saying, like, everything will be okay. Like, let's just run away and, like, not think about it and just get lost in the music. I'm like, damn. And like
so another one that hits close to the soul.
Yeah, and like I know she like broke up with her boyfriend Crissle like
Star,
a while
yes.
ago, but it just made me think of that. I'm like, oh
right. Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I love when, you know, the lyrics can, you know, we felt the same exact way about Bae Gyeong So, you know.
Right,
we're like,
yeah.
Oh, this one's defining us, you
right,
know.
Right, right, yeah.
And then here we are once again.
Right. I like that it's very relatable that she's just trying to, you know, not think about
yeah.
you know what's bringing her down.
Right. Yeah, and you know, it would have been cool if like, you know, maybe they got a little closer or whatnot, or kind of like went for it a little more. But
yeah, I still think they have really good chemistry, though. But I agree. Like, if they like maybe turn it up a notch a little bit, it would have been cool.
Just a notch. That's all I want.
Because yeah, they do look good together.
Yeah. I agree. So yeah. Feeling yet another Dean collaboration.
Yes, he can do no wrong. Knock on wood.
He's really killing it. Yeah, no, I'm hearing really exciting things for him. Yeah. So keep it up, Dean. I'm excited to see what happens later in 2016.
Yeah.
Hint, hint.
And we have last but certainly not least.
Of course, certainly not least. We got a bunch of comments about this, about boy band U-Kiss and their comeback with Stalker.
They've been around for so long.
But yeah.
I feel like they've always been that group who, like, they have, like, really dedicated fans. But, like, I feel like chart-wise and critical reception-wise, they didn't, like, always, like, I don't know how to say this. Like,
well, it just didn't break through as big as...
They didn't break through the way that I feel like a lot of people hoped that they would.
Yeah.
Right. Despite, you know, being on a lot of variety shows, despite, like, everyone knows their name, but...
Yeah. And that's the thing is that, you know, they're certainly big in the K-pop world, you know, and important in the K-pop world, and, you know, been players in that world. But, yeah, just in I guess, you know, if you're trying to find, like, a large...
Jeff's headphones just fell off his
just
head.
Just, like, flopped off my head, but, like, stayed on my neck for some reason. Oh, my God. All right, sorry. what was I saying? Yeah. They, you know, and I guess maybe they never broke through the general Korean public, you know, in that kind of way, which is probably why, you know, the charts might have reflected that, you know. But they held tours in America. You know, the members are certainly known. Well, actually, I feel like we need to talk about the members in particular with this comeback because U-Kiss now, you know,
they've
it's
gone through some shit.
They've gone through some, but like happy shit. Like, you know, they went, some got married.
Yeah.
L.I.E, or is it L.I.E? I think it's L.I.E.
L.I.E.
Is married and has a child. He literally just had a baby the other,
yesterday. Very, very recently.
Like, yeah, he just welcomed a baby boy. In particular, got to give a shout out to @harshpop, who responded to me on Twitter and said they really wanted to hear about U-Kiss's comeback. And, of course, their member L.I.E becoming a father. So thank you for making sure that was on our radar @harshpop. Yeah, I mean, I have several thoughts, but first off, let's just get the single, Stalker is the song.
Yeah.
What did you think of it?
I thought it sounded like very up their alley.
Uh-huh.
They like kind of like this darker electronic dance vibe.
Yeah.
And I thought it was like fine. It's like, to me, it was just a little bit generic because I hear this type of thing from them pretty often, but I thought the concept was cool. I liked, I like the concept of the video. I liked how they put, they actually show like a creeper like in the video watching this girl. I do wish that the video, I guess like switched it up a bit more from the dance scenes. I felt it was a little too heavy on the group choreography.
Yeah.
And they didn't focus enough on the actual stalkers. I think if they had a bit more of a storyline with this girl and the stalker, it would have been like more engaging. I felt like the video, I kind of zoned out after a while because it was just like the same kind of like parking lot scene over and over again. It was fine.
If your, you know, comeback single's called Stalker, go for it.
Right.
You know?
I thought they could have like definitely been a bit more, just taking it up a notch in terms of, you know.
Sure. I would agree with that. Yeah. Because, I didn't think of it at the time, but you're very right, is that there was a lot of dancing, you know. And, of course, you saw those scenes. You know, it's not perhaps the, you know, most wholesome concept in the world, being a stalker. But, you know, if you're going to go for it, at least go for it. You know, commit.
I wanted more of that of that storyline, not just cuts of it and like a quick scene here and there. Like they could have really taken the storyline to the next level and made it like not like, you know, inappropriate or like graphic, but like they could have like definitely put a story in there and you know, just give it more of like more of like an epic kind of like movie cinematic feel to it.
Or you know, K-pop loves a twist at the end. So maybe at the end she was stalking him, you know, or something.
They could have done so much more with this concept, I think.
I do agree. I love the moves though, you know, because they focus so much on the moves. There were those like moves where like they were like peeking out of their hands and stuff, you know.
They like to do that. Okay, so like their like breakout hit was Maman Honey from like 2009. Right. And that reminded me kind of like the overall look reminded me of that, because they were also dancing. It was really dark, and they did a lot of that like hand like by their face kind of like swooping motion. They're really into like the real like the big like gyrations and whatever.
Yeah,
they're a very gyrating group.
Very gyrating group.
So but yeah,
that's
that
going
video,
on their Wikipedia.
They're also, but yeah, like that video was also very like choreography focused, and maybe that but it's interesting how like they kind of went full circle 7 years later, minus a few members.
Minus a few members.
They didn't stray too far from that sound. A little bit less electronic this time, but
right. And here's the thing too, is that I also feel like this song would have been like perfect like 2 years ago or three years ago or something, you know, like this would have been right on trend. Right, you know, right now I think both of us are kind of feeling this vibe that like, oh, it didn't totally you know, it was fine.
Yeah,
you know? music wise and trend wise, right. and you know whatnot. So yeah, I did want, and you know, maybe they could have gone there a little more like music wise with the.
Yeah, it's just like if you played this for me and told me that, and told me to guess which album of theirs it's from, I'd be like, it could be from any of their albums.
Right. I 100% agree.
You know, I don't know.
And you know you. So that's kind of like the music side, in my opinion. But then there's also this really interesting side to this group where, you know, well, they, like we mentioned, they've lost a couple members. Mm-hmm. But they, you know, some of the members are married. One of them has a kid.
Right.
This is sort of the first, you know, if you remember, you know, you look at someone like Wonder Girls where Sun, you know, left, got married, mm-hmm. but then, you know, did leave the group and had a child. But she's, you know, separated from the group.
Right.
I think this is the first group of at least of this generation of K-pop stars that kind of are still promoting in this way. And it's really interesting that Eli's wife might have like almost been in labor when they were like filming this.
Oh my God. The lights just went off in here.
This
always
happens. That
was creepy.
I didn't even
know that happened in this room. Oh my God. I wish that we just recorded that. So like we're in a room where like it's like motion sensor lights. So if nobody moves in here, it just automatically shuts off to like save electricity. So like Jeff just like, because it's shut off because we were just sitting here like sitting. I thought no one was in here. So Jeff like stood up and like did like a big like jiggly wiggly dance.
Gyrated.
To like, yeah, actual gyrations to like get the lights to turn back on. Oh my God. That just made my day.
We got to start filming these.
Jeff has serious moves. Last I saw that, we were at Norebang like a couple years ago.
Oh, yeah. Karaoke. Oh my God.
Yeah. I think there was like, it was like a Pitbull song. I've never seen Jeff like that before.
I'm like that a lot. Don't worry.
Yeah, so well, that was really fitting considering we're talking about UKIS.
I know, but seriously.
Well, no, that's interesting that like this all happened while they were planning this release. So
right. And you know, he's obviously in the video and mm-hmm. you know, is there.
He also didn't give birth. Like,
true.
If it were like, if Sun continued promoting, they'd be like, I feel like this is kind of like the Chrissy Teigen thing again. It's like, she's this model here who gave birth and then went out to dinner like 2 days later, and then people gave her shit for like not being home tending to her child. So it's like, it just made me think of that being like, oh, if Sun had stayed with Wonder Girls, they would obviously be like, you're a bad mother. But like,
totally.
Because Eli's a dude, obviously like
It's
they're gonna be like, oh, someone's at home taking care, rightfully the mom. Like, but that's a different conversation.
It's true, but yeah. I do agree. Well, maybe because I'm like, yo, the dad should be there.
Yeah.
But maybe that's just how I'm thinking.
So
but
who knows how the timeline actually went down.
You're right. But yeah, no. I mean, tell me if this is weird to say, and I'll take it back. But
but you're gonna say. Okay.
Are they like? Now the Backstreet Boys of K-pop, are they like a Backstreet? Because the Backstreet Boys are still kind of like, okay, hear me out. Like, Dana just gave me a look. Like, you know, there's of course like Shinhwa and like, you know, other groups that, you know, are older. But here is like, I feel like the Backstreet Boys kind of like had this moment where like they kind of grew up for a little bit and like, you know, got married, whatnot, you know, had some member changes also. But they kind of tried to still be in the same world. You know, if you remember their last album, like Max Martin, like team back mm-hmm. up with Max Martin, you know, I might be reading all this differently, but I don't know. I almost feel like, is Yuki's the Backstreet Boys of K-pop now? The current, in current form. Or do you know what I'm trying to say? Or am I just really off base?
I feel like it's hard for me to to see what you're saying, because Backstreet Boys, they were already at their peak when all their maybe drama or whatever happened. Uh-huh, so uh-huh. It's like, whereas like UKISS,
we're coasting.
Yeah, UKISS never hit that level of popularity and success.
Okay.
Okay,
I see. It's not like Big Bang.
Right.
Coming back, you know, post-child.
Yeah. Right. And also, I feel like the members, yeah, like you said, the members are all, like, younger.
Right.
I feel like they're not in the same place in their career.
Okay, I see what you're saying. Good point, though.
Like, also, maybe if, I don't know.
The more I think about this, I take it back. this has been a silly episode.
Yeah, I don't know. I think mostly it's just because they're just not at that, like,
okay,
at that level of success.
All right.
Where we can put them on the same plane as BSB.
Yeah, because Backstreet Boys, yeah, they still tour so well in America and everything. And
yeah.
Around the world probably, too. But I will say, I really do like this fact that, you know, and I think UKISS always has been a little more internationally minded, and, you know, they have a lot of English speaking members.
Right,
they had,
right.
It's AJ, right? Who like goes to Columbia or like went to Columbia.
Yeah. And then they had like Kevin Wu.
Right. Yeah.
They had Alexander who left the group.
Right.
And yeah.
But, and you know, I it's clear that they're kind of given a little more freedom maybe mm-hmm. than other groups, which, you know, is cool, I think. I don't know. I kind of like that. I think it's very special, you know, and I think fans probably appreciate it too. Like, you know, that him being married and, you know, having his first child, I feel like it hasn't been as much of a controversy as maybe it should be. You know, granted, it might be due to the place of the group, you know, mm-hmm. in the overall scene, but good for them. Maybe they're happier in the end, you know? So,
yeah.
Gotta give it up to you, Kiss. I hope they're happy.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
But, yeah, I'm sure, like, their longtime fans are just excited to see them again and hear music from them again. And
yeah, I'm sure they are. So let us know if you're one of those UKISS fans that are so happy to see them.
Does UKISS have a fan club name? I don't even know.
I think they do. Are they the Kiss Me's?
That would make sense.
I think so.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Cool. So, yeah, as always, guys, let us know what you were digging this week, what you loved, what you didn't love. And, of course, vote in the poll. Who was your top release of the week? Was it UKISS? Was it EXID? Or was it Heize and Dean? Let us know. Cool.
Yay.
It's time to get into the charts, where we look at the top 5 K-pop songs on U.S. iTunes right now. So, here we go. Now, at number 5, the artist isn't surprising, but the song is surprising. It's BTS with Silver Spoon. Do you know this one?
I don't think I've even heard that.
Silver Spoon, I believe, was originally on the part 2 of the Most Beautiful Moment in Life album. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, but this version, or I think, it was... But the version that's currently trending at number 5 is from the Most Beautiful Moment in Life Young Forever compilation album. Okay. No idea why that song kind of is trending right now. Maybe, you know what might have happened? It's BTS's, like, it's their anniversary this week or something. Okay, and did you see this, that they're, like, doing all this stuff to, like, celebrate their anniversary?
Yeah. Fans are very into celebrating birthdays, anniversaries, you know, all of that.
And BTS is doing a really, because they're giving their fans all this, like, fun stuff this week or this, like, couple weeks. So they might have just released something like really exciting for Silver Spoon. Okay, so maybe it was something like that. I have a feeling. I'm going to go check it out and confirm later. Okay. Number 4. L.I.E. by EXID.
Yeah,
I was kind of...
Okay, so fans are liking it.
So people are liking it. It's doing well here. And, of course, number 3 is Stalker by UKISS.
Check
that out.
That's definitely that higher one's also than I thought it'd be.
Yeah, their album is the top-selling K-pop album right now, too, on US iTunes.
Okay.
So cool stuff. And the top 2 has not changed from last week. It is still number 2, Fire, BTS. And number 1 is Save Me, BTS.
Look at that. Well,
still killing it,
three
boys.
3 out of the 5 spots.
Man, America loves BTS. They will not give them up. Yeah. So let us know who's at the top of your charts, too. Because we love knowing what you guys are listening to, too. And give us suggestions anytime. We're always listening.
Yes.
And last but not least, let's move into our deep cut section. I thought this was kind of cool. I noticed this yesterday on Twitter that CL, you know, leader of 21, currently, well, still to be determined
doing lots
what's
of
happening.
Stuff.
Doing lots of we'll
worldwide
call it stuff. solo album was talked about for a while. We don't know what's going on. Has many updates, but I would say this is a good sign because her song "Hello Bitches" is being used in a T-Mobile ad. Kind of cool because
the video, the ad was really dope.
Yeah, and you know it's cool because you know that song is half in Korean, half in English, and T-Mobile even used like some of the Korean language in it. So I was like, hey, good for her. I thought this would be a nice time to kind of talk about the state of CL, the state of 21, right? The state of YG Entertainment, because right now we're seeing that.
The state of Jeff's
pen. The state of Jeff's pen. I just chucked at Tina accidentally and kicked her while I was looking for it. You guys don't even know what's happening when we're filming K-Stop.
It's wild
in
here.
It is. We have this table that's always shifting on us.
Oh, yeah, that like might flip over at any moment. Yes. Unstable conditions.
Unstable conditions. All of the lights, my pen, my headphones, everything. This has been a silly episode. But anyway. So, yeah, so much is kind of going on. We were also talking about YG Entertainment announced that their new girl group, this long, long-awaited, long-rumored girl group, is finally being unveiled. They started late last week, unveiling the members, going to do one by one, unveiling the members. And I thought this would be kind of a nice time to kind of talk, just have a quick, you know, nice chat about, you know, what's happening? What do we think is happening? Some kind of interesting spice to add to the mix. Dan Suh of Scooter Braun Projects, who, you know, all the K-21 fans and CL fans know, has been a really integral part of CL's kind of advancement and had a big part in Psy's advancement, left the company recently. He announced that on Instagram. So I think there's a lot of interesting stuff at play. 21 is said to make a comeback this summer. Of course, the first one without Minzy. The new girl group is coming. What's happening? And like, you know, what, you know, we were supposed to get this single, you know, this EP from CL, and it never showed up. I don't even know.
Like
where do we even start? I mean, this. So first of all, I'll say this is a cool look for CL, T-Mobile.
For sure.
Putting in the ad. Awesome look. I just don't, I mean, I would like to think that means that things are continuing to move on and ramp on. I know a lot of K-pop fans are really, and, you know, probably us too, are very tired and worn out.
Just, like,
and
almost exasperated.
Yeah, by what's kind of happening with CL. But here's the thing that I always kind of tell people when they're like, oh my God, it's been so long, or like la la la, is that, you know, it's not like the entire world. It's not like, and this is going to sound maybe not so great, but like the entire world doesn't know CL, or at least America. Right. So it's not like she is Harry Styles, who is really well known in One Direction, you know, and whatnot. And Harry Styles was like, I'm releasing music this week. And mm-hmm. then, like, it just never came. Because then people would be like, you're trolling us. But right. CL is still relatively unknown stateside. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's kind of like there's time. It's okay that they're waiting. And I know for the fans, it's so frustrating. I feel ya. I want this music to get out there. But yeah, it's just kind of like, I feel like it's okay that we're waiting, you know? And I can only hope that it's just leading to the right song, the right move, you know? Because I'll be honest, I don't think Hello Bitches was the best move for her. I think it was fine as like a fun viral single or whatnot. Mm-hmm. Did you like that track?
I actually love it.
Oh, well, okay. All right. Well, then, you know, I mean, yeah, I think
it just wasn't promoted the way that I would have liked.
Sure.
I thought it was great. It just kind of flew under the radar for a little bit and, like, was, like, great when it was released, but then it just, like, didn't really go anywhere.
Yeah, and I think that was, I don't think they were looking for it to blow up. Mm-hmm. Or, you know, they put it out for free, you know, and whatnot. But I think, just once they have the right look or the right song or whatever it might be, you know, I do think it really depends on the song is when CL can do this.
Right.
But here's the thing, too, is that there's all these other factors going on, you know?
Yeah.
I guess the state of 21 is a little uncertain because...
I'm confused if, like, if people argue that the using the song in the T-Mobile ad is, like, a sign of maybe things to come. Like, well, then are they... How is she going to promote during the summer if they're supposedly coming back? And then... Yeah. They would be competing alongside the new group. Like, I feel like none of that really makes sense.
Exactly.
So something has to not be
one of these
true.
Things.
One of these things has to not be happening while the others are happening.
Yeah. Which is a little concerning.
Yeah. So, I mean, if they're really coming back this summer, then her solo stuff is not going to be happening this summer.
Yeah, it would seem like it. Or at least, like, you know, or maybe, I don't know. And here's the thing, too, is that, like, I was sort of reading a bunch of, or I was, when I was reading about the girl group, the new girl group coming, I was reading just, I saw a lot of fan reactions of 21 fans, just, like, kind of talking about, because you remember when they came out, right? I thought 21, if anything, got, like, an amazing rollout. Like, they had the song with Big Bang, I think, you know, really high
Lollipop,
fashion.
Yeah.
High fashion videos, a lot of budget.
Yeah.
And I thought they were handled so well at first.
It's because, like, two of the members were already known in within YG, the fandom, because CL has been featured here and there in performances and singles, maybe not credited always, but people recognize her voice.
Yeah.
And then, you know, Park Bom obviously was on a lot of, you know, awesome Big Bang, you know, singles and whatnot. And it's like they didn't have too many of those solo females in the company to begin with. And they've been, you know, trainees for so long that people were just awaiting, you know, like they had already established identities for themselves. Mm. So there was a lot of hype surrounding that. Whereas, like, I feel like this one, like you said, we don't really know anything. It's just they're trying definitely a different rollout plan.
Yeah.
And
that's almost like the unfortunate part. I feel like now, you know, fast forward to now, is that, like, I feel like 21 kind of got, like, gypped in the end, you know, or like, like, I feel like for the last couple years or so, like, probably up until I Love You, which I freaking love that song, by the way, it just seemed like there was kind of confusion on which way to take the group. And, you know, I feel like they delivered when it came to the Crush album. And, you know, that we both love that album. But it just kind of, it felt like things were just uneasy for a while. And it kind of was like, and I really wonder where the Tearing is coming from, you know, like they were doing these like singles, like the Falling in Love single and the Do You Love Me, and then they're like, oh, the album's coming and a single a month, and then that didn't happen, and then they pushed it back, and then it was Crush time, and Crush was great, and then I don't know, it just kind of like I feel like just lately it just hasn't really been working out for 21, which is so unfortunate because they were just such a force for such a long time. Like,
yeah, it's just I always thought it was like tough how CL was trying to always launch the solo career. So then obviously that took away from what the group was able to do, because you can't do as much as you can when your leader and most known member, or I guess at least internationally, isn't there all the time. So you, and then her career wasn't, you know, fully, you know, launched, you know, her solo career. I mean, so it's like, I feel like there's kind of like a, I don't know if stalemate's the right word, but I feel like there's just kind of like a halt as to what is anything going to happen on either end.
And I feel like they almost kind of undervalued CL for a little bit, because she didn't get a solo thing even in Korea, you know, obviously her home base, for what, do you remember that single with her and Minzy, like the, it was like a duo single or something.
Oh yeah, like
but even Dara had a solo single for a while. What was it called? I don't remember.
Oh, Kiss.
Dara had Kiss. Yeah. And then, yeah, and then CL and Minji had that
I know what you're talking about,
that solo song together. And they were kind of being packaged as a duo for a while.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
And then, you know, Park Bom had done her things as well, you know, and did really well as a soloist too. And then I was like, I felt like CL got realized a little later in the game. And then it's like, oh, but you already have this, like, established group, you know. And I felt like it was almost, like, too little too late. And I don't know. It's just, it kind of saddens me just because they were, I don't really know what the correct word is right now. I guess this new song, single, comeback, whatever it is, will kind of indicate where it is. But they were right up there with, like, the other international groups, you know. And I don't know. Obviously, we haven't heard from them in 2 years now. So I don't know. Yeah. I don't know what the state. And, you know, I don't know if this new girl group means they're moving on. I hope it doesn't mean they're moving on, or, you know, it sounds like they're still focusing on the group and going to make it. So I don't know. It kind of, I felt like this T-Mobile ad at least kind of brought a bunch of things to the surface that I think a lot of fans.
I mean, what do you hope happens?
What do I hope happens? I do. Well, here's the thing. I would have hoped Minzy stayed, but that's not going to happen.
That's off the table, Jeff.
So if CL really isn't launching it, if they don't have the right song or the right track or whatever, if it's really not happening, now, let's let 21 come back, you know, this summer, have a great comeback. Doesn't even need to be a full album. Give me a great EP. That's all I need.
Yeah.
And then let that be really exciting. Let that set the wheels in motion for CL to then, you know, come back in the, or not even come back, to really make something happen in the U.S. You know, use all the connections. Get Jeremy Scott to style it. He's bigger than ever, you know. Like, use it all. And then, like, let's, you know, if Dar, but don't let Dar and Park Bom also fall to the side. Like, you know, I think,
like, have them do their own thing in some capacity.
Exactly. Like, I think a big part of the, you know, you remember that, like, Park Bom had this, like, scandal or whatever. Like,
I was going to say, like, that obviously played a part, like, in all of that kind of, like, chaotic kind of period for them.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, she was using prescription drugs that were, you know, which are legal in the U.S. where she got prescribed them, but I guess apparently not totally approved in Korea or something. But I think it was not so great that they remained so quiet on that. You know, if you put out great music, people are pretty forgiving. I think there's a lot of sexism here at play too. I think it's much tougher for a woman to come back from this than you know, the males seem to always get away with this. But you know, I would have loved, I do think staying so quiet was a, hurt them, especially being so quiet for so long.
Yeah.
You know?
I think, like, management and all of that has always been an issue with, like, with YG artists, too. And, like, I don't know how CL's, like, overseas management is how that all works, but I just don't understand why, like, it's like we're moving into festival season, and if you're really going to promote her, why isn't she on any bills for, like, any, on any festival? She's such a, like, Hello Bitches is a great festival song.
Yeah. And if you remember, she was on those Mad Decent block parties
like she
last
knows,
year.
She's friends with Diplo. She freaking, like, an MIA. She's friends with MIA, too, yeah. right? Like, she knows people.
She totally knows people.
So I just, unless she personally opted not to do it or wasn't told not to, I don't know any of that information,
I don't know
like either. I felt like this would have been a really great opportunity this year for her to
that's a good point too. Well,
why doesn't she play festivals? The girl speaks English too. I mean, if like, and I know, and I was thinking maybe there's some weird like requirement when if you're like overseas, but no, like Epic High played, so I don't know
right.
like why.
Oh my god, Epic High played Coachella. And then do you remember when CL was, like, rumored to be on the Austin City Limits, like, lineup, and then she wasn't?
Yeah.
I don't know. Well, okay. So this topic kind of just left me more confused and conflicted and frustrated than I thought it would be. I thought I'd get clarity.
Yeah. But, I mean, I agree with you. I think 21 fans deserve to, you know, have that reassurance that as a trio that they can make it, and that they, you know, aren't just like putting the group aside, you know.
So, yeah.
I mean, especially since they said that they are coming back and continuing as a trio.
Yeah. Oh, but did you also see that he's like, it hasn't been decided if they're gonna add a new member or not?
I did not see that.
Do not. I feel like
do
that
not.
Is
that's
not
no. A, that, that's a terrible.
That is one thing I do not want to see.
No.
Because yeah, it wouldn't
people
be good for
people are not going to accept her in that way, especially when the group was so tight-knit to begin with. When you have, like, such a small group, and I mean, like, under five members in K-pop, it's like the fan base has grown very attached to you. It's not, I'm not saying that, like, you can easily just, like, switch out members in a bigger group, but it's like, you know, YG fans are very protective, and they're very, like, also kind of, what's the word? Just, like, they just grow very attached to their groups, I feel like.
100%.
They're just very protective of their members, so.
Yeah, that's the one thing I don't want to see.
Yeah.
But, yeah, let us know what you guys think of the state of 21 CL, YG new girl group, YG in general. Et cetera.
Yeah.
So many things to talk about. Vote in the poll of your favorite release of the week. Hit us up with more topics for next week, everything else. And, you guys know all the ways. We got Twitter. We got iTunes. We got Heize.tv. Check it all out. So thank you guys, as always, for tuning in.
Thanks so much for listening to us ramble.
Lots of weird shit going on. Yeah. We've been swearing this whole podcast. Yeah. I'm just kidding.
I hope you enjoy the episode. And again, you know, hashtag K-Stop, hit us up.
Yep. So thank you guys so much. As always, this has been Jeff.
And this is Tina.
Thanks so much. Bye-bye.
Bye.